Hey guys, Welsknight here, and welcome back to another episode of House Flipper. I hope you guys are having an awesome day. I'm having a fantastic day. Today, I think I want to do the... Where is it? This one, I think. The House to Celebrate. It's 88 square meters, one floor, six rooms, comfy house in the outskirts. It's just a pretty stereotypical. It looks like it's an apartment, I think. Although I do see windows, so maybe it's not. But let's go take a peek. It's a decent-sized house, but it's not massively big, like some of the other later houses, so it shouldn't take me all day, which is good, because I'm still kind of working on the historic house in the background. Looks like we do have, like, some Halloween decorations and stuff, which is kind of cool. Let's just grab ourselves a little screenshot for the thumbnail. And then we'll see what we're working with here. So it looks like the yard is in need of mowing and stuff. This might actually be a house that's worth doing a garden for. I guess we'll see. But let's... Oh, there's a little bit of trash there. That's fine. Let's head in. Oh, okay. So there was a whole lot of, like, party fiesta type stuff. It looks like Dia de los Muertos, I believe. I'm a little rusty on my Spanish. It's been since, like, high school. But, yeah. This looks like there was definitely a celebration of some sort here. And now the place is a mess. But there's actually a lot of space to work with here. And the room layout is not awful. We got a bedroom here. We got a relatively good-sized bathroom, and we got another room here that we could keep as an office or turn into another bedroom. And then we have this nice, large kitchen here, a living space. Like, I actually think we're pretty much going to keep the same layout. We might even keep some of the same, like, furniture and stuff. We might not actually gut the entire place, because some of this actually looks, like, relatively all right. We might just have to, like, kind of clean it up a little bit, tweak a couple little things that bother me, and call it good. But yeah, first things first, cleaning montage. We'll be right back. Well, my friends, we do have the whole place all cleaned up, which is great. We want to make a couple minor tweaks and changes to things, but I think we're going to do this a little differently than we normally would. I think what I actually want to do is I do want to leave a lot of the stuff and have this be more of like a refresh than like a full renovation, if that makes sense. Because that could be fun. We haven't really done something like that before. So let's give that a try. So a couple things that need to happen. I want to modify these walls just a little bit. I want to get rid of these pieces up here so that we can put a few walls in like so. This fan is kind of in an annoying spot. There we go. Just to sort of separate the kitchen and the living room space. We may end up tweaking the countertops a little bit. We'll see. I don't know for sure yet. But this sort of decorative wallpaper needs to go. Like 100%. It's not doing it for me. So let's just grab some white paint. Probably don't need... We can probably just go with medium. And we'll just paint over it. There we go. Just get that all painted up. Most of the living room, I think we're just gonna kind of leave as is. Like, I'll make a couple of little changes here and there, but... Like, I'm honestly pretty okay with the living room. It just needs some color, I think, because there's a lot of white right now, which isn't necessarily a bad thing, but I think we'd probably want to try and get a little bit more color in here. I suppose one option would have been to repaint the living room a different color instead of white, but I think I'm okay with this, and then we'll use plants and posters and things of that nature. We do want a rug. Let's actually sell that one little cup right there. Let's get a nice large rug. Preferably a colored one of some sort. Maybe like this. Yeah, I think that'll look nice. And let's center it kind of on... Let's put it maybe like right about there. Yeah, that seems good. And then maybe we can do curtains that are also kind of this bluish tone. Like if we go curtains and blinds and we go down to here, like that kind of matches the carpet there on the floor, or at least close enough, right? Yeah, I think that's close enough. It doesn't have to be an exact match to kind of get the effect we're going for. The big thing is I just want to have some splashes of color in here so that it's not so white. And going with a carpet and then those curtains, I think, really accomplishes that. I have to be standing in the room. This light... does not want to go... This is... Okay, you know what? We are going to sell that light. Let's just get a different ceiling lamp. Maybe we'll get the one that's a ceiling fan. Here we go. This one. We'll just put that, like, right... there-ish. I want to center it kind of on the couch. Right about there. Yeah, that seems good. Good. Yeah, that'll totally work. Okay, cool. So that kind of takes care of the living room. I'm fairly good with this. I don't think we need to get any more complicated than this. I think this will work just fine. Might find a way to get a couple more plants and things in here, but nothing too crazy. In fact, let's just go decorations, plants, large, grab our favorite large plant right here, and we'll just put it right there. We can even scoot that back. I want to make sure it's not clipping into the wall at all. But there we go. That'll work. Okay, cool. So there's a living room, which is registering as a home cinema, but that's fine. It's at the end of the day, it's a living room. Okay, so now we need to do the kitchen. And the thing is, this gap is going to drive me insane. So I think what we're going to end up doing is getting rid of all the kitchen cupboards. You know what? Let's actually set some of this stuff aside because we're going to end up using that for other stuff. We'll sell the little wolf and then we're going to sell all of this. Oh, there's a coffee machine right there. Hi, you are also going to end up on a counter. I want to grab white paint again. And we're just going to paint this little bit right here. That's the only part. The rest of this is going to end up being some sort of backsplash, but I don't think I want to use this one. I think I want to use something else. So let's go walls, tiles, sort by the ones from the HGTV DLC, because these are the ones that have the ability to kind of go like a half and half. And let's maybe go with like this herringbone. I think that could look pretty nice. And then we'll just get probably 3 packs of this will be enough, I'm hoping. And we'll replace that with this instead, which tiling is definitely a little time consuming. I wish you could get perks to like tile multiple sections at once to kind of take the tedium out of it a little bit, but it is what it is. Either way, I think the end result with the way that it looks is going to be worth it. So we'll just tile this stuff and then we'll have to go with kitchen counters, and we got a lot of options. We also need to decide if we want to have an actual, like, dining table, or if we just want to have kind of a kitchen island and put, like, some stools against it. Because either one of those choices is very much a valid option. But yeah, I think 3 tile packs looks like it's going to be enough to get us through this whole little section. And then one there and one there. Is that all of it? Yes. Okay. So we can sell that. So, countertops. Let's go all kitchen. So we've got these Imbus ones, which are very flexible, and I like that a lot because there's a lot of options within the Imbus set, like 30 centimeter, 35 centimeter, 40, 45, 50. Like, these are very flexible when it comes to fitting them within a space, which is super nice. There's also the Snowman set, which is very similar in that regard. Maybe that's what we'll do. Maybe we'll go with the Snowman set. And it also has this nice kitchen island, too, if I decide I want to go that route. Yeah, let's go Snowman. So Snowman Light, what we need to find first is the corner cabinet. Right here. And I think we want to go white cabinets. Probably white mat, I think, might be a little better. But then for the tabletop, I want to go with something dark. Maybe not black gloss, black mat. Black marble's actually pretty nice. Does it change the cost at all? No. Yeah, let's go black marble. I think this will end up looking pretty nice once it's all done. We'll just fit that guy in right there. Then I think we want to go maybe a set of drawers, and we said white mat, black marble. Oof, I want to put the sink, like, right here. So this is where the flexibility of these snowman cabinets really kind of comes into play. I really don't want to do with the one with the curtain, though. Do they have a version that doesn't have a stupid curtain? Yeah, here we go. white matte, black marble. There we go. So we're just going to put that centered kind of underneath. Actually, this might be a double window. Or, like, this might be a double sink scenario. No, I think we'll do the single sink right here. Is that centered? Pretty much. I think it needs to move just one to the left, right there. Because this center line of the window should be running down. Okay, cool. So now we can grab something like this. This is a 40 centimeter one. And just see. Okay, looks like we got to go 45. Which should be in here, right? Do they not have 45 centimeter? Yeah, here we go. White mat, black marble. Bada bing, bada boom. It fits flawlessly. And then we can do the same on this side. And then I think our refrigerator is going to go over here. So let's just search for refrigerator, and I want to grab the big stainless steel snowman refrigerator, which will go right there. And then we will change this from a 45 to a 50 centimeter. If I can find it. 50 centimeter. And this is what I'm talking about when it comes to the flexibility of some of these counter sets. Some of them really let you get things exactly the way you want it, which I really appreciate. Okay. So now we also want a oven. And I don't think there... Oh, there is. There is totally an oven right here. Okay, cool. So let's grab a small cupboard, maybe like a 30. We'll put that right here. And then we'll get the... you know what? Let's see if maybe we can get a range for this that works a little better. Like, does this end up being the right size? Not quite. What about the... In this one? That is a real... That's very expensive and also way too big. This one might work. How's that fit? Yeah, it's a little down below the countertop, but... I think that's okay. Like, I'm actually good with the... No, I'm not. Let's not do that one either. There's gotta be an oven here that works better with this, right? Ooh, there we go. There we go. Now we're talking. Okay, yeah. So we've found our oven range. So that's good. And then we can just basically do counters the rest of the way around. So, we go back to Snowman Light. We grab our corner cabinet here. Get the right colors. Fit that thing in right there. And then we just grab a couple more cabinets and basically call it a day. So let's do a couple of the 80 centimeter ones. Get a couple of these nice drawers. And then this looks real tiny. This looks like maybe like a 25. Is there one that small? 25. Beautiful. Right. Oh no, that's actually way too small. Looks like we actually need to go up to like maybe 35 even. There we go. So we have our kitchen. Obviously, I still want to get some other things in here, like That's where I want to put the microwave. Maybe like here. Maybe kind of like rotate it a little bit. You know, kind of like the classic corner microwave. Get a toaster in. We can put that kind of by the microwave, maybe. Put that like right about there. Coffee machine can go over here by the fridge. Knife block can go right about there. Beautiful. And then we'll get some cabinets in. So we'll go snowman light. We definitely want some overhanging cabinets. Let's see. Snowman light here. White mat. Everything else can... Ooh, that's real tiny, though. Is that really all the taller they get? That's so small. Like, are they all... Yeah, I guess they are all really that small. They just... Okay. Okay, hey, that's fine. It is what it is. Yeah, I guess we'll just go for it. So, white mat. I said white mat, right? There. To match everything else. And then we'll just get a couple. Okay, we need a 40 centimeter for there. Which should exist. 60, 50, 40 white mats. Put that one here. Actually, you know what? I like having a little bit of a separation. Oh, yeah. I just realized we also have an oven that needs a range hood. So let's go even smaller. Let's go 35. And now you're seeing kind of why I cut a lot of stuff out of videos. Because it's going to take us a while just to get this one little section of the kitchen done, just to redo the cabinets. Because it's a lot of, like, going back into the store, grabbing what you need, taking it back out, putting it back in, yada, yada, yada. So we'll put that here and maybe just leave it like that. And then we can maybe fit in another one over on this side right here. Like, not a huge one, but just a little bit more cabinet. Can go a little bigger than that. Like, right about there. So we do have some cabinets. We could just skip the range hood as well, but I don't think I want to do that. So let's go with a hood. I believe this is an 80 centimeter range. Yes, it appears to be. Okay. So let's make sure we have this as the colors that we want, which is essentially stainless steel. And I'm just going to put that, like, here. I don't know, maybe we could have cabinets going across up there. Snowman light. Just out of curiosity, if I grabbed a couple... ...45 centimeter. I mean, I know this is not a real one. This is like a dummy one. But it could end up looking good. We just bring that down. Do another one there. Yeah, I think I'm good with that. Just to kind of sort of bring it all together. And then I think we just leave it like that. Like, that seems a great, seems like a great kitchen. It does need an island or a dining table, though. And I think we're going island. I think that'll look better. So let's go furniture, kitchen. We'll go back to our snowman light. We're going to grab this kitchen island right here. Make sure it matches everything else. Top. We want that sticking out, so we're going to go right about here-ish, I think, for a nice decent sized kitchen island. Is that right about where we want it? Maybe bring it a little bit to the right. Just so there's a... Yeah. Yeah, I think that's a little better. And then we'll get some stools. Some, like, bar stool type things. Furniture, dining room, bar chairs. There we go. Now we're talking. And let's just do something like... I don't know how I feel about that. Maybe we go light gray for the... Yeah, I think that's a little better. We can just go, like... one, two, three. Just have a couple of, you know, sort of bar stools. We can even scoot those in a little bit. I think we'll move them up. There. Yeah, that seems really nice. That is a nice kitchen. Last thing we need in the kitchen is just ceiling lights. That's super important. You gotta have good lighting in the kitchen. Let's do this guy. Let's put that like right there. And then when you smack the light switch, yeah, there we go. Nice. And then I'll accessorize some things and whatever, but I think that's a very nice looking kitchen. This I'm happy with. And then I'll make a couple tweaks to the bedroom and the office as well, but nothing super crazy. And then we'll basically be done. Oh, and the bathroom. I'm gonna have to do stuff at the bathroom too. Okay, my friends, I think the refresh is completed. So here's our hallway. Didn't really do much here. Swapped out the light, threw down a rug, added a little coat hanger over here, and threw in a plant just to kind of bring it all together. Real simple. We've already been over the kitchen and the living room since we did those together. So let's start with the bedroom here. Kept the same bed, changed out the rug for this kind of very light blue colored one, added in some blue curtains, a couple of blue plants. There was a radiator here that was horizontal that I got rid of to replace to put a vertical radiator in over here and put a bookshelf here instead. So I could put some plants and stuff on it. That's basically all I did to the bedroom. Then here in the bathroom, I made a few different changes. We kept the tub, but the sink and the toilet I swapped out, as well as this cabinet. This was just a big mirror. I swapped it out with the cabinet that matches the sink. Added a white chest of drawers over here with a couple of little plants, with like a couple of flowers here and some towels. Put a painting right here. I think I actually want to scoot this up just a little bit now that these flowers are there. Threw in a corner shelf. Put in this towel rack and this towel, but didn't do, you know, the bathroom is very similar to how it was. Like, it works. Oh, and this gray carpet as well to kind of fill that floor space and break up the white a bit. But yeah, this is the bathroom. Nice and simple. And then finally, for the office, I didn't do a whole lot in here either. I swapped out the carpet for one that's a lot more neutral. I added in another bookshelf, a vertical radiator over here, this bookshelf, this whiteboard, and this painting. And then I just kind of readjusted the things, you know, straightened a couple things out, move this a little bit over to the right, you know, little minor modifications like that. But that's pretty much all I did. So yeah, there we go. There's our refresh. The biggest change was definitely the kitchen. I don't think I want to do a garden competition on this one. So let's just go ahead and try and sell it and see how it goes. Let's give it a go. So it looks like we spent roughly $80,000. And okay, didn't make a whole lot there. Let's see if we can maybe negotiate that up. Let's be a little greedy. Let's see if we can negotiate that up all the way to like another $5,200. If they say no, they say no. There we go. So we made about $10,000 in profit. It's something. I accept your offer. Let's get some before and after pictures. You can see a lot of these are going to be almost identical. just kind of, you know, cleaned up the place a little bit. Moved a couple walls, nothing too crazy, but still, I think I'm happy with it. Like, it was kind of a cool little thing to, rather than trying to essentially redo the entire house, just sort of update it a little bit and fix a few things. So, probably won't do that again for a future episode. I'll probably go back to my normal renovate the whole thing style, because I think that's a little more fun overall, but... yeah, just wanted to try something a little bit different for this one. Guys, if you enjoyed the video, you know what to do. Links in the description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, my friends, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.